playing the character for the third time, do you have a feeling that you now know what the real essence of Kirk is, what makes him that captain?
No. I just kind of take it film to film, really. I enjoyed doing this one because it seemed to, a lot of what Kirk was going through resonated with me. It's a lot of the things that drive you in one point of your life, the impetus to do something that gives you really so much focus and energy and fire. At a different time in your life, they don't serve you anymore. And I know that Kirk in this one is finding himself in that precise spot where the energy and the drive to live up to his father and to rage against the system that killed his father and to be the best thing ever, to compete with the legacy of his father, just doesn't work anymore. So he's got to find something new. And I think what he finds is that he just loves his friends. He loves his family. And that's good enough for him.
I mean, do you worry that Kirk's meant to be such a great captain, but it seems like the longer he's in charge, the worse the ship gets destroyed.
I know. Well, hopefully he's charming enough to get past his abysmal record. I don't know. You make a valid point.
I think he might be just charming enough.
Yeah.
The Spock-Kirk friendship has always been right at the heart of Star Trek.
Spork.
Why do you think these two characters need and love each other so much?
Charming.
I think they balance one another in a really remarkable way. I think their energies, their natures, their perspectives are
potato, potato.
Both diverse but complementary. I think that they are
savory yet. Just trying to liven things up.
Too early to go off the rails.
I know.
I feel like they learn a lot from one another, and I think in the first two films they were working to understand each other to a degree where now I think, like, even though they're not together in this film, they don't spend a lot of time together. I think their energy and their connectedness sustains and actually really helps. You know, they have the shorthand now, and I think they've come to accept parts of themselves through their relationship with one another. And I think that's really all you can ask of any friendship or connection with somebody.
And talking about love, obviously the decision to reveal Sulu as a major LGBT figure for the franchise has generated a really strong reaction. How do you feel particularly about that element of this story?
I mean, I think the reaction that it's generated by and large has been enormously positive. And to see the response, especially of young people who are so inspired by and heartened by this very tasteful, subtle, and yet impactful reality, I think is so exciting. I think all of us are really honored to be a part of it. You know, of course, we all love and respect George Takei and his relationship to this character. His contribution to this franchise has been absolutely indelible, and I totally understand where he's coming from. But I also hope that he's ultimately heartened by the sense of evolution and progress and inclusion that this represents. And I think it's really meaningful and exciting. I think we're all on the same page about that.
Fans were a little bit surprised maybe not to see Alice back. Was there a reason for that? And do you think that given the importance of the characters, you know, in the other timeline, that's something we might see in future films?
I'm the last person to find out anything. So, the decision to bring back Alice, I don't really know what that was about. We all love her, and she's a great part of the franchise, and I'm sure we'll make a return if and when we make another film. I think the excitement with Sophia playing Jayla is introducing a new character and a new species or what have you, and particularly, I think what Sophia brought to it that was very important. Again, this movie's a lot about family and friendships and federation and unity and the fear of inviting someone new into your collective space. And Sophia brought a real sensitivity and a real physicality to the part that I have no idea what that means in comparison to what I just first said, but I know that that's an important part of it. Zach?
Chris is, I think, involved in some kind of an egg and bacon coma right now. we miss Alice. I love Alice. You know, we still stay in touch, and we were sorry to see her not come back for this one. But you know, I feel like, it's all about energy and new energy, and we're thrilled to have Sophia. She brings such a sensitivity, a vulnerability, and yet a power and a strength to this character, and I think audiences will really respond to her and want to see more of her for sure.